Hello everyone and welcome to another episode of the Daily Roundup. I'm Anushka and let's take a look at the top stories for today. The Ayodhya case in the Supreme Court today was adjourned again after the exit of Justice U U Lalit, one of the five judges in the Constitution bench. Justice Lalit recused himself after one of the petitioners in the case brought up the fact that in 1994, U U Lalit was the lawyer for Kalyan Singh in a case related to contempt of court. Kalyan Singh was the Chief Minister of Uttar Pradesh when the Babri Masjid was demolished in 1992. Chief Justice Ranjan Gogoi said that the bench would be reconstituted in order to fill Justice U U Lalit's now vacant seat. The matter has been adjourned until January 29th. The passing of the redrafted Citizenship Amendment Bill on January 7th by the Union Cabinet was met with widespread protests across Assam and the Northeast. Agitators in Assam have been blocking roads and rail tracks, seeking revocation of the bill. In Guwahati, members of 70 organizations led by Akhil Gogoi's Krishak Mukti Sangram Samiti and Assam Jatiyabadi Yuba Chhatra Parishad protested outside the central government offices and also tried to make their way through the barricades to the state secretariat, which led to a scuffle with the police. The Assam Gana Parishad, or the AGP, has pulled out of the alliance with the BJP, and other allies of the BJP are not too pleased with the passing of the bill either. BJP spokesperson Mehdi Alam Bora resigned from the party. Former Assam Chief Minister and AGP leader Prafulla Kumar Mahanta demanded that the BJP government in the state resign and fresh elections be held. Forty-nine MPs from both the houses have written a letter to HRD Minister Prakash Javadekar highlighting the irregularities and misgovernance by the JNU administration and also expressed anguish at the current state of governance in the Central University. Following the appointment of M. Jagdish Kumar as Vice Chancellor, JNU has witnessed a storm of changes, from violating the constitutionally mandated reservation system to attacking teaching and research at JNU, to the harassment of students as well as teachers. The VC has challenged the very tenets on which the university was founded. The letter mentions how student safety and welfare, as well as the integrity of the faculty selection process, were being undermined in the university. It also accused the Vice Chancellor of disrespecting the parliament. The letter points out how the skewed priorities of the administration and the repeated violation of the JNU Act, statutes and ordinances have put at stake not only the university's teaching-learning process, but also the future of thousands of young students seeking a solid education in high-quality and affordable publicly funded universities. The Foreign Minister of Iran is on a visit to India to discuss a variety of issues. The issue of Afghanistan is likely to have figured in the talks. This comes even as the latest round of talks between the US and the Taliban that was scheduled to be held in Doha on January 9th was cancelled. The Taliban had raised objections to the proposal for the Afghan government being part of the talks. Iran recently conducted a round of negotiations with the Taliban, and Iranian sources said that they were willing to use these contacts to aid India if needed. They added that it was important to view relations between the countries of the region from a post-West perspective, whereby the West, and especially the US, is not seen as the major factor determining what happens in the region. Iranian sources also added that the security of one country in the region must not be at the cost of the security of the others. Incidentally, this has been China's position on the Afghan issue as well. It is in this context that Iran seems concerned about countries which depend on the US for their security in the region. Currently, Saudi Arabia and the UAE on the one hand, and Qatar on the other, are at odds against each other on discussions with the US and the Taliban. It's unclear what will happen to the latest round of talks between these players. For India, however, whose view of Afghanistan is often completely dominated by the Pakistan angle, Iran's perspective and approach could provide a useful lesson. That's another episode of the Daily Roundup. If you'd like to get a more detailed analysis on these stories or other stories, you can always go to our website www.newsclick.in and you can watch more videos on our Facebook page and on our YouTube channel.